Sarah really needs no introduction, but I will introduce her. Sarah is the legend in the entrepreneurial world, the founder of Spanx. And so, Sarah, thank you so much for being
here. Thank you for having me.
All right. So let's start at the beginning.
Okay.
So you were a frustrated consumer.
I was.
And you decided to try to solve a problem. What was the problem you were trying to solve?
Well, I couldn't figure out what to wear under white pants. And I was a frustrated consumer. The undergarment options at the time were not great, right? We had underwear that left a panty line, girdles that were really thick and uncomfortable. And then they invented the thong, which just put underwear exactly where we had been trying to get it out of. So, so I was like, yeah, no. And listen, at the time that I invented Spanx, and for the guys in the audience or some of the ladies who don't know what Spanx is, it's just I invented an undergarment that filled the gap between traditional underwear and those heavy-duty shapers. And I was interested in giving women a smooth canvas. Like, I love clothes, I love, you know, to be able to wear them, but just like a painter, if you don't have the right canvas, it affects the whole painting. And the options weren't great, and they could be seen, they left lines, they left bulges. So that's what caused me to invent the first product, which was the first ever Spanx, the footless pantyhose.
So you started with $5,000.
Yes.
An idea. And you went down to South Carolina to talk to these enlightened men in the manufacturing plants. How'd that go?
It was interesting. You know, when I first thought of the idea, well, let me back up for 1 second. I actually really manifested the idea. So, you know, it's like everyone's always like, how did you take an idea and then start a business? Well, it's how did you even come up with the idea? You know, I was in search of my idea. And at the time, my life was not great. I was selling fax machines door to door. I was living with my mom. I was like 25 years old. And I remember after a whole entire day of being kicked out of office complexes again all day, or sometimes my business card ripped up in my face, I pulled off the side of the road one day, Kathy, and I was like, I'm in the wrong movie. Like, what just
happened?
Call the director, call the producer. This is not my life. This is not my movie. And I went home that night and I wrote down my strengths or what I thought I was good at. And the only thing in the good column really was sales. And I thought, okay, well, I know I'm good at selling. What is it I like about selling? And I realized I like offering something to someone that they need or didn't know that they needed that can improve their life or help them. And so in that moment, I wrote down in my journal, I want to invent a product that I can sell to millions of people that will make them feel good. And and you know what? And 2 years later, the idea came to me. And I was ready for it. You know, women had been cutting the feet out of their pantyhose for a long time. And I only did it one time, but I had already asked the universe for my idea. And I said, when it comes, I will not squander it. And I will take it and run with it. But then when I ended up at the, you know, I didn't know where to go. I'd never taken a business class. I had never worked in fashion or retail. I had no industry contacts. I went on the internet and started looking up hosiery manufacturers, and they were in North Carolina. And I called them on the phone relentlessly and didn't get anywhere. And so eventually I took a week off of work and drove in person. And it was such an eye-opening experience for me. I mean, for them too, I'm sure they didn't really know what to make of me because
right.
I had my lucky red backpack with me. And I would just show up unannounced to manufacturing plants. And they would always ask me the same 3 questions. They would say, and you are? And I'd say, Sarah Blakely. And they'd go, and you're with? And I'd say, Sarah Blakely. And they'd go, oh, and you're financially backed by? And I'd be like, Sarah Blakely. And they'd be like, oh my God, so nice to meet you. Good luck, girl, you know. So that's, you know, that's how it all started, is just beating on doors and trying to get someone to help make the idea.
Your dad is very important in your life, and he taught you a lot about failure and the way that you think about failure. Mm-hmm. No doubt there were small failures along the way. Help folks understand your philosophy around failure and what you learned.
Well, growing up, my dad used to encourage my brother and me to fail. So at the dinner table, he would actually ask us, what did you fail at this week? And if we didn't have something to tell him, he would actually be disappointed. And I can remember coming home from school and being like, Dad, I tried out for this and I was horrible. And he'd be like, way to go, and high-five me. And what It was such a gift what he was doing. I didn't realize it at the time, but he was redefining failure for me. And so failure became not about the outcome, but about not trying. And so, you know, the fear of failure, as we all know as entrepreneurs, is one of the greatest fears in life. It's one of the things that stops us in our tracks and keeps us from trying something. And so I incorporate that in my philosophy at Spanx. We celebrate failures, we talk about them, we have oops meetings where I'll announce the oops that I have, and sometimes we have fun with it. We'll even attach theme songs to our oops and we'll play them in front of the whole company. But I think it's just so important to try to get the people that you work with to take risks and to be entrepreneurial and not live in a place of, I want to protect my job and feel like I'm not safe if I make mistakes. That's tough. And one of the things I also do is I like to go up to people at Spanx and I say, I'm always trying to get people off autopilot. Like, if you think about it, everything we do, almost everything we do in life is autopilot. We're doing things exactly the way someone else showed us how to do it or taught us how to do it. Well, if you're doing things exactly the way everyone else is, there's not going to be any real significant change. There's not going to be a really meaningful potential breakthrough. So I always go up to people at Spanx and say, if nobody showed you how to do your job, how would you be doing it? And I'll say, just sit with that. You know, I'm always, like, I'll stop myself often and just say, okay, you know, this is how I've been doing it, but is this right? And give yourself the time to think about it. So I ask people to do that.
The beautiful, the talented, the generous Sarah Blakely.
Thank you.